Hello and welcome. I like playing games on their original hardware just as much as the next guy, but it's really hard to ignore the temptations and benefits of emulation. Not only will you be able to play your games on any device with cross-platform saves and whatnot, but you'll also be able to continue playing your games even after the hardware has completely fallen apart. At least until the emulator refuses to even start without some arbitrary firmware or BIOS files. Well, if, like me, you've already put the effort in to go and back up your physical games in the first place, then it's not too much of a stretch to go and obtain your own BIOS files from your own hardware, at least if you have the right accessories. So today I'll show you how I was able to back up my BIOS files for my PlayStation 1, 2, my Nintendo DS, and Game Boy Advance systems. But before I do, this video is brought to you by us and the 16-bit store. If you're looking to spruce up your collection by displaying your consoles or cleaning up your controllers, then why not check out what we have on offer at 16-bit store. Heck, if you have an e-reader, we even make fully repairable e-reader cases. If you're interested in anything that I've been stating or you want to support the channel, why not visit 16bitstore.com today? The links will be in the description below. Now, not every emulator requires a BIOS files, and if you're familiar with playing Game Boy Advance games on RetroArch, you'll probably know that most GBA cores don't need a BIOS to play the games. Well, the reason for that is partly because sometimes the system just doesn't need the original BIOS to work. But other times, especially with the Game Boy Advance emulators, they do require one, but the community has developed open source versions or open source compatible BIOS files that work. For example, GBA temp user Normat created the open source BIOS for the Game Boy Advance that's used in a lot of modern day emulators. If you go into any of these libretro cores that use it, you'll find a reference to or a compiled version of Normat's BIOS. If you were to, let's say, download that BIOS file and just force the emulator to boot from it, you will see that it does work and without issue. So if you have an older PSP and you're looking for a GBA BIOS, this is an excellent spot to get your hands on one without getting original hardware. And it's not just the Game Boy Advance that has its own open source BIOS file. PSX Redux is an open source reverse engineering project for the PlayStation 1, and this team developed their own open source BIOS, which actually apparently works with original hardware. But in our case, it works perfectly fine with DuckStation, and all you need to do to get it is to download the PSX Redux Windows build and just get the open source BIOS and throw it in. From my testing, both the Game Boy Advance BIOS and the PSX Redux BIOS works perfectly fine with most of the games, and I've not noticed any significant differences between it and the official BIOS files that you can still get from the original hardware. I'll go into those later on in the video. While I will recommend using open source BIOS files when possible and thank the communities who are making them, there is a possibility that you can get official BIOS images from the internet with some work without having to raise the Jolly Roger. At least that's the case for PlayStation 1 and PlayStation 2 files. You see, Sony's been bundling the PS1 and PS2 files with PS3 firmware updates for years now, and thanks to the YouTube channel Easy on the Eyes and the Retro Game Corpse channels, there are easy tutorials for how to get them. But it is genuinely dead simple and straightforward. All you have to do is download a PS3 update file, download the RC PS3 emulator, and install the firmware update to the emulator. Then all you need to do is download the BIOS claim tool and run it as the README describes. in the main folder, and you'll get your hands on not only a PS1 BIOS, but a PS2 BIOS, which works excellently in DuckStation and PCXS2. If you want a more detailed description, I'll link Retro Game Corp's website, as it has simple links. Also link below the archive.org repository for the BIOS claim tool, as it has a good README guide for how to get everything. But not every system will have its own open source BIOS files or have a way to claim a BIOS file from a system update. If you have a Nintendo DS, for example, and want to play a DS game on your iPad, you will need original hardware and a way to run Homebrew on it. And that's going to be probably the biggest wall into emulation that you will find. Being able to get the BIOS is actually quite easy. It's usually just in one system package that's runnable in Homebrew, and it just dumps it for you. The hard part is actually getting to the point where that system can run the Homebrew in the first place, either because the hardware is expensive or the process is convoluted. So I'm going to go through how to dump your BIOS files from a couple of systems just to show you how to do it and what you'll need to do it. For PlayStation games, dumping the BIOS requires no special hardware to actually dump the files, since the PlayStation 1's copy protection is easily bypassable if you're quick enough with the CD swap trick. This method allows you to run pirated PS1 games or backed up PS1 games on your PS1 system, or in our case, allows you to run the PS1 dumping tool on the hardware. This tool dumps the PS1 BIOS into 5 parts to the PS1 memory card. And here is where you're actually going to run into a problem, because now you have to find a way to dump your PS1 memory card to your computer. Now, you could buy third-party PS1 memory cards that'll save it to an SD card and you're good to go there. But if you don't and only have official hardware, then you're going to either need a USB to memory card adapter, which are elusive, or you'll need a modified PS2 or PS2 that can run Homebrew in order to go into UELF launcher to copy the raw data from the memory card and MC paste it onto a USB flash stick. You have to use MC paste or else it will not copy over correctly. I had this happen twice and it was not fun. But once you've copied over the raw save files, then you can use a PSX memory card manager like MemCardRex to go and insert it into a virtual memory card format that the BIOS merge tool that comes with your BIOS dumper can recognize. And once you're done, run the program in a terminal and you have yourself a complete PS1 BIOS. Enjoy the classic blong every time the system boots. On that note, you can also use the same method on a PSP in order to get the PSP's PS1 BIOS. You'll have to convert the PSP's PS1 memory card saves so that it works, but the process is effectively the same. For PS2 BIOS files, in order for you to dump it, you're going to need to run Homebrew on the PS2, and to do that, you're going to need one of these. This is a PS2 memory card with free MC boot installed on it. You can buy these on eBay for like next to nothing, and it's highly worth to get your hands on one of them. But if you don't want to spend the money or don't trust these things, then what you can do is you can buy yourself a PS2 to SATA adapter, plug an old hard drive in, or get yourself a SATA hard drive of low capacity, and copy the free HD boot image file to the drive. I'll have links below for where to get that, as well as some guides to go and install free HD boot. To get the BIOS, all you really need is a free MC boot, but if you use free HD boot, you'll get access to things like the OpenPS2 loader that'll let you go and not just run your PS2 games from the hard drive, but also have virtual memory cards that'll allow you to have infinite save files, which is a godsend compared to how small these things are. Plus, with a free HD boot installed, you can also create your own free MC boot cards, so it kind of leads as a good backup utility. Once your PS2 is capable of running Homebrew, then I'll highly advise you to go to the PCXX2 website and go to their gathering files page. It's an excellent wiki guide for how to go and dump your BIOS files, and it'll most likely keep up to date with which dumper utilities you will want to get. Currently, PCSX2 is recommending a BIOS utility called BIOS Drain, and all you need to do to run it is to put it onto a USB flash drive, plug it into your PS2, load uLaunch Elf, and go to your USB and run the program. It should dump it automatically, though if you run into issues where it can't see your flash drive, you may want to switch it with another flash drive, since it does have a little bit of compatibility with maybe older or some newer drives. I had to go through two before mine would work. And when you're done, just load the files into your emulator and it'll work perfectly. For the Game Boy Advance BIOS files, there's actually a couple of ways to get it, and you don't even need a Game Boy Advance if you have a 3DS with Virtual Console games installed onto it. But if you have a Game Boy Advance or a Nintendo DS, the easiest way to get the BIOS file is through the Easy Flash or an EverDrive and the BIOS dump ROM. Just put the ROM onto an Easy Flash and run it on your system. Wait for the screen to go from red to green, and you're good to go, because the game will generate a save file that contains your BIOS. Now, the save file will be pretty big, so all you need to do is run the included Python script to trim the save down so that it just contains the BIOS file. If you don't have Python installed onto your system, it's pretty easy if you go through the terminal and type in Python. If you're on a Windows system, it will instantly open you to the Windows 10 store, and it'll let you download and install it so that it will work. Now, there is another way to get your hands on a Game Boy Advance BIOS file if you have Game Boy Color or Game Boy eShop Virtual Console titles on your 3DS systems. If you watch our How to Extract ROMs video, you'll see a specific file as you're browsing through the ROMFS folder called agb.bin. Believe it or not, this is the complete Game Boy Advance BIOS file just sitting there mostly unused from what I can tell. All you have to do is just dump this and you're good to go. To get your hands on the Nintendo DS BIOS and firmware files, all you'll need is a simple flash cart like this R4 cart or any of the modern ones that you'll find on Amazon or eBay. This is something that I highly recommend in general, but all you need to do is download the dsbfdump.nds file and just put it on the root of your SD card, launch your DS or 3DS systems, and just run the applications. When the process is done, you'll find a folder on the root of your SD card that contains all the necessary BIOS and firmware files. And the process for getting your BIOS from other systems that I haven't mentioned is usually follows the same format. And with a BIOS file and emulation, I am shocked with just how far the technology has come. I never dreamt of a day that I'll be able to take my Apple iPad, plug it into a third-party monitor, and play proper dual screen DS with a controller and a functioning touchscreen, let alone being able to see the PS1 Harry Potter games in widescreen or seeing PlayStation 2 games run at 60 frames a second. It's absolutely shocking just how far emulation has come in the last few years, and I really need to explore it in more depth in a future video. But anyways, thank you ever so much for watching. I hope you have yourself a good day, and as always, take care.